Excellent customer service. That's the mantra I repeat to myself when I walk into my office every morning as I start my day at the City of Novi assessing office, and it has been my personal mission as a professional in this career over the past 30 plus years. Hello, I'm Micheal Lohmeier, and I'm your city assessor here at the City of Novi. Keeping with my mission of providing excellent customer service, I'd like to take a few minutes and talk to you about your 2021 notice of assessment and point out some things that you might find of particular interest. First, you'll see a comparison of the 2020 and 2021 assessed values and what some refer to as state equalized values. This represents what we believe is half of your property's market value. For example, if your assessed value is $150,000, then we believe your property is worth $300,000. Your property's assessed value is based on how your property physically exists as of tax day. In Michigan, tax day is December 31st, so all properties are assessed in 2021 based on how they physically existed on December 31, 2020. A property's physical characteristics include items such as its land size, the house or building size, the quality of construction and overall condition, whether it has a garage or not, whether it has a basement and if that basement is finished or not, and any other value influencing characteristics which enhance or detract from its value, such as porches, decks, fences, patios, and any known related functional obsolescence. Market related changes in value each year are made based on assessor sales studies. With any increasing market conditions, we use 2-year sales studies, while with any declining market conditions, we'll rely on a 1-year sales study. For the 2021 assessment year, the City of Novi used a 2-year sales study, which included sales having sold between April 1st, 2018 to March 31st, 2020. Next, I'd like to review with you your 2021 notice of assessment for your change in taxable value from the 2020 to 2021 years. Keep in mind that your taxable value can never be higher than your assessed value. There are occasions when the taxable value may be the same as your assessed value. First, the year after a property sells will cause its taxable value to uncap. At this point in time, its state equalized and taxable values are the same. Secondly, in cases where the assessed values are declining in an area, a property's assessed value may decrease below its prior year's taxable value, again causing the value to be uncapped to the lower amount. Again, at this point in time, its state equalized and taxable values will be the same. Other than ownership transfers and reductions in assessed values, the only other actions which cause the taxable value to change is the inflation rate multiplier and physical changes to the property. Each year, the state publishes an inflation rate multiplier to apply to every single taxable value in the state, regardless of location or property type. So if you haven't changed ownership and you've made no physical changes to the property, then the taxable value should only go up by that inflation rate multiplier. This year, the inflation rate multiplier is 1.014 because the consumer price index was 1.4%. That means your 2020 taxable value multiplied by 1.014 should be your taxable value for 2021. Provided there's not been any physical changes made to your property throughout the 2020 calendar year and nothing's been corrected regarding your property physically throughout that same time period. For example, if you've added a new deck or finished off an area that previously wasn't completed, such as a basement finish, those kind of changes would be considered additions to taxable value and would be outside of that increase caused by the inflation rate multiplier and would increase the taxable value beyond the 1.4%. On the other hand, if no physical changes were made regarding your property in the 2020 calendar year, your taxable value would only increase by that 1.4%. So let's assume your property's taxable value was $100,000 in 2020. Then $100,000 times the inflation rate multiplier of 1.014 would calculate a 2021 taxable value of $101,400. So your assessed value could be $120,000, or it could be $150,000, or anything above that $101,400 amount. You're only going to be paying taxes on that lower taxable value calculation. So we strongly encourage you double check your taxable value amount on your assessment notice. And if you've made absolutely no changes to your property during the 2020 calendar year, but you've noticed your taxable value increase beyond that 1.4%, then call our office. We can double check the reasons for that change. Mistakes do happen, and we appreciate your help and involvement in correcting our records when they do. I encourage all our residents to review your assessment records. They are yours. The main record to review is your house sketch, which contains your outer wall measurements or dimensions. These are used to calculate your home's gross living area, or most people refer to by acronym GLA. This is the primary driver for the valuation of your home as it relates to the size of your home and is then added to your land value. Our sketches are available on our website for your convenience for accessing. If you don't have a computer, you can always call our office for it or stop by anytime and we can print one off for you. If you're not available to come into our office, call our office and we can email that sketch to you. The last important piece of information I'd like to give you today is to tell you about our March border review. Earlier, I said that your 2021 assessed value multiplied by 2 is what we believe your property's market value is as of December 31st, 2020. If you believe we have your property overassessed, then you have two options. First, you can always call our office and discuss your opinion with us regarding what you think it's worth and why. Share with us any information you have. Information about the border review is on the back of your assessment notice. However, I just want to point out some important dates for scheduling with the border review. The board meets from March 8th through March 10th this year. That's a Monday through Wednesday, with Tuesday the 9th being the afternoon and evening meeting to accommodate working person schedules. You will need to fill out a petition for the appointment and bring in any information you have to provide to the members. The information that is usually brought includes other property listings and sales which support your contentions about the property's value. If you're interested in coming to the board, call our office and we can schedule that appointment, and we can also provide you information about that meeting. As always, if you have any questions about what I've covered here today in this video, anything about your assessment records or March border review, feel free to call our office. You can ask for me directly. We have a tremendous amount of information on our website at cityofnovi.org. Again, thank you very much. Thank you.